I'm Sara Sims. I'm here in St. Louis, originally from just outside Atlanta, Georgia. In 2000, I got married to my husband, Joe. I was helping him get his degree through college, and once he finished that, we decided we were ready to start a family. I got pregnant. That's when Joey came, and he was our first. And when he was born, he didn't pass his newborn hearing screening. And over the next couple of months, I noticed there was this change in Joey. He wasn't responding to sounds like he used to. So I called the audiologist in Atlanta at the deaf school, went in for the hearing test, and when she came out, she had that look on her face, and I just knew. I knew that he was deaf. That started my journey in life. Everything changed. We met with the doctors and they told us about this thing called a cochlear implant. And then he had his surgery at 19 months and he was activated or turned on at 20 months. It was the first time that he really could hear things. During this whole process of getting him this implant, I find out I'm pregnant with our second son. And I have his brother, Aaron, and we're in the hospital, and they take him away for that newborn hearing testing, and when the nurse comes back, she had the same look on her face that the audiologist had. It's hard enough to hear it for the first time with one kid, but the second time just really hurt. And I remember my husband and I just crawling in the hospital bed together and holding each other and holding Aaron and just crying together, but knowing that we could get through it. After I had my first two kids, I was done. There was so much work and doctor's appointments and surgeries and therapies, and I was working as well with my business. I just felt like I never had any downtime. And we were getting to our groove with Joey and Aaron. We thought, hey, you know, we could have one more. And so we decided, all right, I think we're gonna move forward and go for this third baby. Soon after, I found out I was pregnant with my third little kid. We're in the hospital. I'm psyching myself up. I'm ready for whatever diagnosis we're gonna get. Cameron's getting his hearing tested, and it finishes about an hour later, and she said, he can hear. And that was just a great moment as a parent. It was time for me to change paths. And I decided I'm gonna go back to college and I'm gonna get a degree and do something that I can help other families. And it was time to come out and visit Washington University. And that moment was amazing because I walked into the room and they all stood up and not only just said hi, or you think they're gonna shake your hand, but instead I got hugs. Like, welcome, we're so glad you're here, we've been waiting for you to come. Here I felt from day one that I was important to the PACS program, to Washington University, and I felt like I was a family member. And the whole meeting was all about, we can't wait to have you come here. We can't wait to have you in our program. And I'm just so lucky to have Washington University, the PACS program, behind me, teaching me everything that I need to know to be successful and a great audiologist.